¿Quién da a esta mujer para que se case con este hombre? La muestra bien, ella y su familia. Aunque muy bien, gracias. Sure, sure. Usted puede. Ahora sí puede sentar usted. Okay. Gracias. Ahora se quita el batallar. Him up, yeah, makes sure he's good. Thank you. Are you okay now? Everything's fixed. Good. Okay. I'm going to do this in Spanish and English, so it's going to be a little lengthy, but I'll try to hurry as best I can. Vamos a estar en inglés y en español, solo que va a tardar un tantito. Si se sienten que se van a desmayar, acuéstense en la tierra para que no se caigan. Okay. You didn't get that. I said, if y'all feel like you're going to pass out, just lay down on the ground so you don't fall too far. Is that okay with you? Good. Okay. Y'all can get a little closer if y'all want. I mean, it's going to be okay. I won't tell nobody. I guess they're nervous. I'm going to pop a pill. Just hang on a second. Is he going to do what? My mouth is very dry, and usually these cough drops help. I forgot to do it before. I'm sorry. I'm just delaying everything. Is the meals already done? The meal's on wheels here?
I think so.
Okay, very good. So let me do this, because y'all are very nervous. Dear family and friends, we're here today to be a witness to God joining these two young people. And I say they're young because they're younger than I am. Okay, they're probably old already, aren't you? About 50-something. Yeah, okay. And they're going to declare their desire to be united in this holy matrimony, the presence of God and you as witnesses. So you are very important this morning. Or this, is it morning? It's afternoon, isn't it? I keep thinking the sun's out, so it's got to be morning. But I'm sorry. And this is an honorable before God and should not be taken lightly. It should be with discretion and with godly fear. And if he doesn't have godly fear, he better have Diana's fear, okay? Okay, all right. Este estado de matrimonio, unir al novio y la novia, es algo muy importante. Sus deseos para este tiempo, y en la presencia de Dios y ustedes que vinieron, les damos las gracias que están aquí con nosotros esta tarde. Así se formaron los primeros vínculos de este sagrado pacto de matrimonio pronunciado por Dios en estas palabras. Génesis 2:18 dice: no es bueno que el hombre esté solo, le haré ayuda idónea para él. Okay. No malinterpreten idónea, no es doña, es idónea. Okay. Porque creo que les digo, porque tengo muchos problemas cuando ella es doña y no idónea a su esposo. I'll get you in just a minute. It is not good. Bible in Genesis 2:18 it says, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helpmeet for him. In Spanish, there's a word that comes up with not necessarily helpmeet, but it's one that you have to know what you're talking about, because otherwise she will assume authority over you, and that sometimes is not good. Okay, and she usually has the equipment to get your attention: frying pan, broom, stuff like that. And you got to be careful with that. En Génesis 2:24 dice: por tanto dejará el hombre a su madre y su padre y se unirá a su mujer y serán una sola carne. Genesis 2:24 says: therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. Okay? Right now, you're two. You can tell, one, two, or one, two, whichever. Now you're going to become one in the eyes of God. Okay? Like I told you, you're going to be responsible, my man. Okay? It's going to fall on your shoulders, lock, stock, and barrel. She's going to help, though. Okay? Is that right, Miss Diane? Yeah. Thank you. Okay. Let's pray before I get y'all so upset at me you'll want to leave. Father, we thank you for how good you've been to us. We're thankful for this beautiful day you've given us. Everything is going just as good as we can expect it. Father, you've been good to these young folks. I pray you bless Brett and Diana, that you'd be with them, their children, their house, their family, their household, and all you have. Thank you for these folks that have come out to be with us today, to honor them in being witnesses before God, and Father, that they might be prayerful in all the days to come for this couple. Damos gracias, Señor, por la bendición de este día, hermosura del día, y todos los que están aquí presentes delante de ti para acompañar a Brett y Diana, que esté con ellos. Gracias te doy por sus familias. Bendícelos, cuídalos en todo. En Cristo te lo pido. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Y'all can be seated. You have to stand. Okay. Ahora si se pueden sentar todos también. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? It's okay. Okay. Y'all might be here. Y'all get here in a minute. The rest of y'all get here. Okay. Here comes the important part, my man. I'm going to give it to you in English so you won't have no problem. Okay? ¿Y el tuyo en español? ¿Está bien? Okay. In case you're wondering, I'm going to give Brett's in English so he knows what I'm talking about. And I'll give Diana's in English with a little bit of Spanish in it so she'll know what I'm talking about. Is that okay? Very good. Y'all are very cordial this afternoon. Okay, Brett. Do you take Diana to be your lawful wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward in this holy state of matrimony as the Lord has ordained? Do you promise to love, honor, protect, respect, and take her in sickness and in health, in good times or bad, for richer or for poorer, in prosperity or adversity, and rejecting all other women, and keep your eyes and your heart on the Lord Jesus Christ, so you can be faithful to Diana as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Thank you. Had you worried for a minute? That pause. Ay, como que no quería este hombre. Ya me lo iba a cachetear ahorita mismo. Okay, Miss Diane. Tuve que quitarle una palabra porque no le gustaba a Diana. ¿Dónde está la mamá Diana? ¿Usted, verdad? Voy a tener que hablar de usted después al rato. Okay. Diana, ¿tomarás a Brett como tu amado y legítimo esposo para vivir juntos en el santo estado de matrimonio según lo ordenado por Dios? ¿Prometes amarlo, honrarlo, respetarlo, cuidarlo y obedecerle y cumplir todo lo que él necesita en enfermedad o en salud, en los tiempos buenos o en los malos, en riqueza o en pobreza, en prosperidad o adversidad, y rechazando a todos los demás hombres, y mantener tus ojos y corazón en nuestro Señor Jesucristo para hacerle una fiel esposa a Brett mientras que vivan los dos? Okay. What happened to the Spanish? That's okay. That's okay. Y'all can sit down now. Amen. Okay. Yeah, hold the chair. Very good. Okay. I'm just going to give you a few scripture references. I'm going to talk to Brett and Diane personally, and maybe it'll be a help to you also. I am not trying to change anybody's, religion or anything like that. I'll just give you scripture references. Voy a tomar la Biblia para ayudarle aquí a Diana y a Brett para que sepan qué están haciendo. Muchos no saben. No saben. ¿Por qué no saben? Okay. Proverbs 18:22, it says, "Whoso findeth a wife findeth a good thing." You have found a good thing. Okay, but don't take it as a thing. Okay. She may not like that. This Bible, it says, "And obtaineth favor of the Lord." Your blessing comes because you have chosen a good woman. Not a good thing. I don't, things don't sound good. She's not a thing. Okay? You got that? Okay, I didn't cover that too much. Hebrews 13:4. It says, "Marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled, but whoremongers and adulterers God will judge." You're doing the right thing before God. A lot of people don't want to do this. Okay? It's a good thing for your children. It's a good thing for your family. It's a good thing all the way around. In 1 Timothy 5:14, it says, "I will therefore that younger women marry, bear children, guide the house, give none occasion to the adversary to speak reproachfully." So I think you work, don't you, Dan? Did you tell me you work? Yeah, okay. Be careful. Yeah. You be careful at your job. You be careful at your job. Why? Because you're not together when you're working. You work in a different place, don't you? You must be sweet today, my man. There's a honeybee after you, but that's okay. In Colossians 3:18-19, it says, "Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as it is fit in the Lord." You submit to him like you're submitting to the Lord. Why? Remember I told you the other day? The goods and the bads come through him. The blessings, okay? Because if he don't do right, it's going to be a long year, a long 25 years. Okay, I hope he stayed that long, at least that long. You can go to 50 if you like. I won't object. It says, "Husbands," here comes yours. You ready? "Husbands, love your wives and be not bitter against them." Okay? It says wives and them, but you got one and that's all you're getting. Okay? No smile. I don't know what's wrong with him today. The sun must be too hot. Here's the verse I want you to write down, memorize, whatever it takes. 1 Peter chapter 3 and verse 7, it says, "Likewise, ye husbands, dwell with them according to knowledge. Give honor unto the wife as unto the weaker vessel, and as being heirs together of the grace of life, that your prayer be not hindered." Basically, this is what you'll never understand her. Okay? 80-90% you might. But the 100%, no, it ain't happening. I was married 50 years, and my wife in the last few years of about after we had completed 45 years to 50, she came up with some stuff. I said, "Where did you get that?" And I don't know what it is. I didn't understand her. I don't think she understood herself. And now you ladies are just brilliant, and you ladies here in the audience, y'all understand everything. Nobody nods your head. Are y'all here? You need to help this girl. You need to help her. Okay. Let me go do it in Spanish now, okay? Same thing, different verse. Proverbios 18:22 dice, el que haya esposa, haya el bien, y alcanza la benevolencia de Jehová. Las bendiciones, favor. Dios bendice al matrimonio, al hogar, a la familia, por medio del hombre que anda haciendo las cosas bien. Solo que hay que cuidarlo, hay que orar por él. Cuando anda mal, mamá, ya sabes, un sartenazo para que se le quite. Porque yo sé que Diana no lo va a hacer. En Timoteo, 1 Timoteo 5:14 dice, ¿quieres pues que las viudas jóvenes se casen, críen hijos, gobiernen su casa y no den al adversario ninguna ocasión de maldicencia? Simple y sencillo, pórtese bien. Los dos. Okay. That just means behave yourself, both y'all. Okay. I thought I had to do something different. Colosenses 3:18-19 dice, casadas, estad sujetas a vuestros maridos como conviene en el Señor. Maridos, amar a vuestras mujeres y no seáis ásperos con ellas. Okay. Hay muchas cositas que si les pregunta a cada marido aquí, cada esposa aquí, no van a saber lo que estoy hablando. Digo yo, no sé. Y es nomás bíblico. No le estoy dando nada aparte de Biblia. Okay. Y el versículo que le dije a Brett que memorizara, que no fallara, era en 1 Pedro 3:7. Dice, vosotros maridos igualmente vivir con ellas sabiamente. Que use un poquito de sabiduría. Dando honra a la mujer como a vaso más frágil y como a coherederas de la gracia de la vida, para que vuestras oraciones no tengan estorbo. ¿Okay? Orar, queremos que Dios los bendiga, Dios haga algo con ellos y con cada uno de nosotros. Una pregunta, question. ¿Okay? The most important love you will have besides the Lord is husband or wife. For you, it'll be your wife. For your wife, it'll be you. That's the most important. After the Lord now. The Lord's first. Then the husband comes in, the wife comes in, the children come in, and then the rest of the family. Okay, you said, I never heard that. Trust me, it works. Okay, that's the most important love. Okay, who of y'all answered that question? The most important love after the Lord is husband, wife, children, and the rest of the family. Brothers, sisters, mom and dad and all that. I know our culture says, no, mom is most important. And I understand. But what are you going to do with God? What are you going to do with your husband? You're one. You're not two anymore. You're one. So we got to keep that in mind. This is the verse that Diana don't like. And you may not like it either. Or verse is. And I'll be done after I finish reading these. Excuse me. Ephesians 6:21. I won't read all of them, but I'll read a few. It says, submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God. Wives, submit to your own. Husbands, as unto the Lord. Submitting yourself as one to another in the fear of God. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be subject unto their own husbands in everything. Now you say, that's iffy. Don't get married. If you cannot submit to your husband, if you don't trust your husband, if you think he's an idiot, don't get married to the man. Okay, it's simple, simple mathematics. Okay? Then it goes to the husband also. If you think your wife is just off out there somewhere, don't marry her. I don't say live together either. I'm not saying that. I just say don't marry her because you're going to have problems. Okay? Wine and dine or whatever you want to do, and then y'all can talk and y'all can learn things of each other. It's not hard. It's not hard. But you have to do it that way, otherwise you'll be in bad shape. That was just one verse. I know you didn't like it. Husbands, here we go. This is for you. I know I had one for you. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. What did Christ do? He came, was born, lived a perfect life. They crucified him, and then they buried him, and he rose again the third day. What does that mean? That means you have to protect her from everybody. Bill collectors, meatballs that are meatballs. And you just got to protect her. Don't take it for granted she'll protect herself. Just because she's a black belt in karate, that don't mean nothing. You have to protect her, okay? Shake your head. Thank you. Okay, appreciate it. Okay. Whew. Okay. So I'm trying to help you, Diane. I really am. Here we go. Okay, enough funny business. Let me do it in Spanish real quick, and I'll let y'all breathe a little bit. En Efesios 6:21, unos cuantos versículos, dice, someteos unos a otros en el temor de Dios. Las casadas estén sujetas a sus propios maridos, como en el Señor. Porque el marido es cabeza de la mujer, así como Cristo es cabeza de la iglesia, la cual es su cuerpo y él es su salvador. ¿Qué? Muy simple, ¿verdad, mija? Para que tú no sufras, que tú no te mortifiques, no te suba la presión, no tengas un embolio, ataque corazón y cosas así. Okay. Es fácil. Maridos, dice, amar a vuestras mujeres, así como Cristo amó a la iglesia y se entregó a sí mismo por ella, para santificarla, o habiéndola purificado en el lavamiento, del agua por la palabra. Te voy a regalar una Biblia al rato. Tienen una Biblia en la casa, parece que me dijiste. Es bilingüe, así. Tú la puedes leer en inglés o español y es nomás en inglés. ¿Okay? 5-10 minutos todos los días. ¿Okay? 5 minutes to read your Bible every day. With Miss Diana. I'm going to give you all a bilingual Bible. That way she knows exactly what... She says, well, I don't understand that in English. She'll understand in Spanish. Okay? It's real simple. To me, it's simpler in Spanish. I don't know why. But anyway... Okay, I will not further the beating, okay? Okay, I want y'all to stand. Here's where it gets good. Mm-hmm. Okay, now you can put your bouquet down there on the chair, and I want you to look at each other, eyeball to eyeball. Hold your hands. There you go. Now look at it. Don't look at me. I don't want you to look at me because I'm not marrying you. Okay, you got that? Okay, very good. Now, you're going to be doing some repeating. You want it in English, right? Okay. You don't want it in Spanish? Is he awake?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Here we go. Oh, you're killing me, fellas. I better get the English. I got the Spanish ready. Okay, you ready? You're going to repeat with me, okay? I, Brett. Take you, Diana.
Take you, Diana.
As my lawfully wedded wife.
As my lawfully wedded wife.
That we too.
That we too.
Will become one flesh.
Will become one flesh.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
I promise.
To love.
To honor.
To protect.
To respect.
To respect.
And fulfill all that you need.
And fulfill all that you need.
Spiritually.
Spiritually.
Physically.
Physically.
Emotionally. Emotionally, there you go. Okay, she's emotional. She's getting emotional already. So take it easy. It's okay. Scarf, excuse me. You done lost me on emotionally. Okay, and take care of you.
And take care of you.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
In good times or bad.
Good times or bad.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In prosperity or adversity. 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 No diversity. No. You're losing me on that one. And rejecting all other women.
And rejecting all other women.
And maintain my eyes.
And maintain my eyes.
And heart.
And heart.
On the Lord Jesus Christ.
On the Lord Jesus Christ.
So that I may be a faithful husband.
So that I may be a faithful husband.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Wonderful, sir. Wonderful. That wasn't hard, was it? No. Diversity, no diversity, no. Adversity. Okay, Miss Dan, you want it in Spanish or you want it in English? You tell me. Spanish is okay? It'll be okay.
If you messed up, I'll mess up.
Okay, here we go. Te tomo a ti, Brett. Como mi amado y legítimo esposo, para vivir juntos en el santo estado de matrimonio, según lo ordenado por Dios. Prometo amarte, honrarte rispettarti,
cuidarti,
obedecerti. I thought we were going to get in that. Obedecerte. Come on, Luke, do that to me, girl. You heard? Thank you very much. Y cumplir todo lo que necesitas. En lo emocional, en lo físico y espiritual. Prometo ser fiel en enfermedad o en salud, en los tiempos buenos o en los malos, en riqueza o en pobreza, en prosperidad o en adversidad. Not diversity, no. Y rechazando a todos los demás hombres y mantener mis ojos y mi corazón en el Señor Jesucristo para ser una fiel esposa mientras que vivamos los dos. Okay, my man, I need your rings. You ready with the rings? Or did you lose them already? Oh, okay, there they are. Okay, we're good. You might have gone and knocked them. I don't know. I'm sorry. Yeah, he just gives it to you. You get the big one, and Brett gives the two small ones. See that piece of cake? God, I love it. Thank you, sir. All right, Daniels. Okay, you've chosen a ring, a circle. Okay, it looks like it has no end. Never had a beginning, but I know it had a beginning, but it's a complete circle, and it's like the rainbow that God put for Noah. Whenever he brought destruction on the world, he put a rainbow. He says, that's my promise to you. I ain't gonna do it again. Basically, he's telling him, you behave yourself and I won't do it again. But he said, I'm not gonna do it again. And he hasn't yet, except a couple of days ago. El anillo es algo hermoso, algo redondo, se considera. Parece que no tiene fin y parece que no tiene comienzo, pero tuvo que comenzar en algo. Y así debe ser el amor. Comenzó y ahora espero que no tenga fin, que sigan amándose uno al otro. Your love started and I pray it's going to continue. Amen. If not, I'm going to go beat you half to death. Okay. Okay, you ready to repeat with me, sir? Okay. Yep, I better get the English. Hang on. Okay. You ready? You're going to go first. And then she goes after you. Okay.
I'm going to repeat after
you. Oh, you're going to repeat after me. You are too, yes. Everybody's going to hear it. Everybody's going to be a witness. And you ain't going to get out of it. Okay. Okay. You know which finger to put it on, right? Okay. Very good. You got it. I know she knows. Okay. I lost you here. Okay, with this ring,
I be wed,
and with everything I have,
I share with you.
And by this ring, I declare before God, and these witnesses, that I will be a faithful,
loving husband.
And if you don't, oh my goodness, go ahead and put it up. Con este anillo me caso contigo y por este acto declaro ante Dios y de estos testigos que te tomo como mi esposo y seré fiel y amorosa esposa. Seré fiel y amorosa esposa. Very good. You can put it on his finger now. I'm done with that part. El siguiente porción tengo que hacer en inglés porque este muchacho no sabe en español y tienen que los dos juntos repetir conmigo. Okay, you ready? Hold your hands now. Come on, don't be holding each other. Hold your hands. Come on now. You're losing me. I want you to repeat both of y'all together with me. Okay, I'll tell you what's said in just a minute. It's different. Okay. With these rings. We declare before God and these witnesses that we will be faithful one to another, and it will be a symbol of the covenant we have made with each other and God. That wasn't too bad, was it? But don't forget, I'm going to remind you every now and again. I'm going to send you a text message. Don't forget. You know what it's going to be about, okay? Okay, don't go away. You're doing fine. We didn't have the last one. Okay, very good. You said you had a Bible, right? Okay, I've got one in the car. It's bilingual. I have the one that normally goes to the brides. Okay, except I ran out. I didn't want you to have a quinceañera Bible, so I don't think you want it. Okay. Oh, my goodness. Okay, now, take a step that way, both of you. Very good, thank you. Because I can't fit back in these chairs. Okay. Okay. Psalms 119:105, it says, "Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path." 2 Peter 1:19 says, well, I think it says, what did I do with it? Did I lose it? You're not going to believe it, but I got to know Spanish. That's not good. 2 Peter 1:19. Yeah, well, now I goofed up. I'm sorry. Let me find it real quick. Says, "We have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto ye do well that ye take heed, as unto a light that shineth in a dark place, until the day dawn and the day star rises in our hearts." The day star is Christ. The prophecy is coming back. Until he comes back, we've got to be ready for him. Read your Bible. Most important. You're not going to please me. You're going to please God. Okay? God's going to bless you, bless her, bless your family. Real simple. Real simple math. We want God's blessings. Almost done. Don't go away. Here comes a difficult part. Okay. Put your hand like this. There you go. Thank you. You put yours like this. Put your other one on top. Put that on top. We're going to pray. Okay. Father, we're thankful for these two young people. Have decided to this union, this covenant with you. Father, I pray your blessings on them. I pray you be with them, give them wisdom and understanding, that you would change their hearts and minds, and Father, that you would be with both of them in these difficult times. Bless their children, that they may be one in teaching and showing by example what they need to do, and Father, that you'd help us in all that we do. We thank you, Lord, for these folks that have come out. We're thankful for the young couple. Father, it's something interesting, exciting, something to behold in the future as how they place or take this day and keep it fresh in their minds of the love they have for each other and the words they have explained to others and explained to themselves of what God is going to do, wants to do, and can do in their lives. I thank you, Lord, for what you're going to do. I thank you for these folks that have come out. Bless each one. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay. You're not going to believe it. We're almost done. In Mark 10:9, it says, "What God has joined together, let no man separate." Okay? This is the start of two lives. It will be the beginning of a new family. You say, well, they were already together. I understand that. But this seals what God wants and has for them. You'd be surprised when somebody gets married, when a couple gets married, how much they have that they didn't before. They have declared a desire to unite. in the state of matrimony before God and you as witnesses. And by me as a servant of God, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Brett and Diana Stapleton. Now you may kiss your wife. If you want to stay up here with me, stay up here with me. If not, you'll pick. Take your bouquet. Here's your bouquet. There you go. Vamos ponernos en pie, let's stand.
Yes. Let me see you move.
Well, you can go all the way to the top and come back down if you want to. Still, you don't want to.
Let me see you move.
Yeah.